Hello everyone, this is SK Singh from DPS Method Refinery. Dear children, we will solve a few more questions based on the concept of relations and functions by another method, method number one. Method number two we have discussed yesterday, where a function f a to b y equal to fx is given to you and we are to prove the invertibility and finding the inverse. The method was, we will create another function g b to a such that g o f x equal to x and f o g y equal to y, then function f is said to be invertible and g is the inverse of f. Now we'll prove it by proving 1 by 1 in one step, ontoness or surjectivity in another step, and then finding the inverse. Look at question number 7. Here the function f x equal to 4x plus 3 and function r to r. We have to prove that function is invertible and finding the inverse. So here, considering f x equal to 4 x plus 1, 1, 1 s, let us consider x1, x2 belongs to domain and r such that f x1 equal to f x2. And here f x1, from here you can see f x1 equal to 4 x1 plus 3, f x2 is 4 x plus 3. So 4 x1 plus 3 equal to 4 x2 plus 3. On simplification, we have x1 equal to x2. So here we have proved that x1 x2 belongs to R, fx1 equal to fx2 implies that x1 equal to x2, therefore the function is 1 1. Now we'll prove the ontoness of function. For ontoness, we have to prove that codomain equal to range. Here the function is fr2r, so here codomain is real number and domain is also real number. Now first of all we'll create an expression x in terms of y. You can see here y equal to 4x plus 3. So here you can see x equal to y minus 4, 3 by 4. So x is nothing, x is gy or f inverse y, if we are able to prove the function is onto. Now look, we have taken any arbitrary element in the codomain R. What is the codomain here? Here codomain is R. And for corresponding to this element y, there exists an element x in domain R where x equal to how much? X equal to y minus 3 by 4, such that fx equal to how much? Y. It means we have taken any arbitrary element y in the codomain and there is a corresponding element in the domain y minus 3 by 4, and y minus 3 by 4 is associated by function f to the element y. It means any arbitrary element of y have pre-image in domain. It means that all the elements of codomain have pre-image in domain. So therefore, all the elements of real number of codomain are nothing but the range. So here range equal to codomain. Therefore, the function is onto. So we have proved that function is 1 1 as well as function is onto. That is, function is injective plus surjective and the function is bijective, therefore function is invertible. And what is the inverse of the function? Whatever expression we have obtained x in terms of y, here x can be written as gy and g can be written as f inverse y. So here in place of x we will write f inverse y, and f inverse y is how much? F inverse y equal to y minus 3.4. So we have proved that function is 1 1 as well as it is inverse function is y inverse y by 3. Now look at question number 8. Here the function is f r plus 2 4 to infinity and function is x square plus 4. Prove that the function is invertible and finding the inverse, and where r plus is the set of all non-negative real number. See, r plus is the set of all non-negative real number means it is a set of 0 and positive real number. Now we will prove 1 by 1. Let us consider two elements x1, x2 belongs to r plus such that fx1 equal to fx2. You can see here. And fx1 is how much? Fx1 is x1 square plus 4 and fx2 is x2 square plus 4. Here you can see fx1 equal to fx2. So here 4, 4 get cancelled. So x1 square equal to x2 square. On taking the square root, we have x1 equal to plus minus x2, right? Since x1, x2 are the positive real number, so neither x1 nor x2 is negative. It means both are positive, therefore x1, x2 can never be negative. So we'll ignore this negative sign. So x1 equal to x2. So we have proved that if fx1 equal to fx2 implies that x1 equal to x2, therefore the function is 1, 1. Now we'll prove on to ness of the function. How can we say the function is on to? Here, the codomain of the function is 4 to infinity. Codomain of the function is 4 to infinity, where 4 is included. If we are able to prove that range of the function is also 4 to infinity, then we can say that codomain equal to range. So here, let us first of all, we will create an expression x in terms of y. So we have placed y equal to x square plus 4. 4 to take into the left hand side. So x will come out plus minus y minus 4, under root y minus 4. And you know that x belongs to the positive real number, x belongs to r plus, so x can never be negative. So we'll ignore this negative sign of the x, and the x equal to under root y plus 4 is the function relation. And x equal to y plus 4 is the relation. So, and x equal to under root y minus 4 will be the required relation. In place of x, we'll write f inverse y if in case we are able to prove the function is onto. If x equal to under root y minus 4, x belongs to 0 or positive real number. It is possible when y minus 4 is greater than equal to 0, because you know if there is negative term inside the under root, it is an imaginary number. So for y minus x to be real, y minus 4 should be greater equal to 0, and y minus 4 greater equal to 0 implies that y should be greater equal to 4. Y equal to greater equal to 4 means y belongs to, you can see y belongs to 4 to infinity, right? Y belongs to 4 to infinity. So therefore the range of the function is 4 to infinity, and here codomain equal to the range. So here the range is y greater than 4, and same is the domain. Codomain equal to range, function is onto, therefore f inverse x exists. And x in place of x, we write f inverse x or f inverse y, or f inverse y is how much? F inverse y equal to under root y minus 4. So we have proved the function is 1 1 onto, and hence we have find the inverse of the function. Now look at the another question, question number 9. This is also one of the very important question with the board point of view. Here you can see the f r to infinity this, and function this is the function is this, and 9x square plus 5x minus 5 is the invertible function, and finding the inverse. So first of all, we will prove the 1 1 s, and we know that if x1 x2 belongs to r plus, such that fx1 equal to fx2, then we can say the 9x1 square plus 6x1 minus 5 equal to 9x2 square plus 6x2 minus 5. You can see minus 5 and minus 5 get cancelled, and this x1 square, take to the left hand side, 9x1 square and plus 6x1 minus x2, right? If we take 9 common, x1 square minus x2 square plus 6x1 minus x2, and x1 square minus x2 square can be written as factorization x1 minus x2, x1 plus x2. So here you can see in this expression, you can see that x1 minus x2 can be taken common. So x1 minus x2, and here we will have to be on 9x1 plus x2 plus 6. Now look at this function, last step. In this step, you can see it is the product of two terms, x1 minus x2 and 9x1 plus 9x2 plus 6. The product of two term is 0. It means either first is 0 or second is 0 or both are 0. And since x1, x2 belongs to positive real number, means x1, x2 belongs to positive real number, therefore 9x1 plus 9x2 plus 6 can never be equal to 0. Right? So the product of two term is 0 and one term can never be 0. It means the another term is equal to 0. That is x1 minus x2 equal to 0. Or x1 minus x2 equal to 0 implies that x1 equal to x2. So we have proved that if fx1 equal to fx2, then expression is x1 equal to x2. Therefore, function is 1, 1. Now we will prove one ontoness. In ontoness, we again will prove that if codomain equal to range, then function is onto. Let us create a function x in terms of y. Here one method is given to you, we have taken common, but I will suggest you do in different way. Look at this function. You can see 9x square is 3x whole square, right? Or plus 6x. 6x can be written as 2 into 3x. So you can see a square plus 2ab is here, where b is 1. So it can also be written as 3x plus 1 whole square minus 6. If we rearrange that term, first two term, 9x square plus 6x, right, or minus 5. So 9x square plus 6x, make it a perfect square. The 3x square, 3x whole square plus 2 into 3x into 1. So 1 is to be added and 1 to be subtracted. So first bracket will become 3x plus 1 whole square minus 6. Y equal to 3x plus 1 whole square minus 6 minus 6. So if we take 6 to the left hand side, it will come y plus 6 equal to 3x plus 1 whole square. If we take the square root, so under root y plus 1 equal to under root y plus 6 equal to 3x plus 3. So on rearranging the term, we will have the final under root y plus x minus 6y3. So you will have the expression which is given here. So here we'll get this term x equal to under root y plus 6 minus 1 upon 3, where x belongs to r positive. Here, if in order to have a r positive, on simplifying, if we are able to prove that the codomain by minus 5 to infinity is the also the range of the function, then we can say the function is onto. Here, let us consider if arbitrary element y belongs to 5 to infinity, then we have a function, an element x in the domain, that is r plus, says that where x equal to under root y plus 6 minus 1 upon 3, such that fx equal to y. If we are fx, we have this, and in place of x, we have this expression which we have now here. So in place of x, we have under root y plus 6 minus 1 upon 3. So in place of x, we'll write this expression. So 9 into this expression is square plus 6 into this expression is square minus 5. And on simplification, we have that it is equal to y. So for any arbitrary element, y belongs to R 5 to infinity. There is a corresponding element x in domain r plus such that fx equal to y. Therefore, we can say that codomain equal to range. Therefore, the function is onto. And whatever x we have created here, it is nothing, it is the f inverse y. So, here we have f inverse y equal to this. So this question we have solved in two ways. One by theorem g of x equal to x and f g y equal to y, as well as by proving 1, 1 and ontoness. So you have to opt any one method, either this method which we have discussed today or the method which we have discussed yesterday. We can solve the question. Thus we have come to the end of this chapter. So relation function chapter is there. One assignment has already been given to you. I sincerely advise you to solve all the question, and whichever is not, please let me know. I will give the solution of those questions. We'll proceed to the next chapter, that is matrices determined, in the forthcoming videos. Wish you all the best. Stay safe, stay blessed. God bless you.